Kobe Bryant is one of the greatest players to ever play the game of basketball, spending 20 years as a superstar for the Los Angeles Lakers. He has played with some all-time greats during his career, where he's managed to win 5 NBA championships and put up career stats of 25 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists per game. So the last 3 seasons of Kobe's career were kind of riddled with injuries, which ultimately made him retire by the age of 37, but it's no doubt in my mind, if he were completely healthy, he could still contribute to this day to an NBA team at roughly the age of 39 or 40. So recently, the Golden State Warriors actually called up Kobe Bryant. He was jokingly talking about it, saying that they offered him a contract to come play in a bench role for the Golden State Warriors to try to win a few more rings out there. So for today's video, we are going to see what if Kobe Bryant accepted this deal, came out of retirement, and played for the Golden State Warriors. Yo, what's going on, guys? Crispy Flakes here. So we have Kobe Bryant on the Golden State Warriors in the 2018-2019 NBA season. I think this would be absolutely crazy to watch. Now, I put him at roughly like a 79-80 overall player just because I think of other players that played late in their career, like Ray Allen and Vince Carter, guys like that. If Kobe Bryant was completely healthy, I think he would definitely still be a top, at least bench player in the NBA. So yeah, man, we got him with a pretty decent jump shot there. Not absolutely crazy, but you know, pretty decent out there. And I'm just really excited to do this video, man, to get Kobe Bryant back here. Unfortunately, he does have like a 66 dunking just because I'm sure he's not throwing down like the man once used to do out there. So yeah, just kind of nerf his stats a bit here based off the fact that he is older now. He still is injury prone and stuff like that. But yeah, man, let me know in the comment section below if Kobe Bryant was to play for the Golden State Warriors. I will say, it does kind of make sense because he is the Black Mamba and there is another snake in Kevin Durant on this team. So who knows, man? But yeah, let me know in the comment section below. If he played about 20 to 26 minutes per game, what do you think his stat line would be right now if he was healthy? I think he's going to put up roughly like 13 points, get about 3 rebounds and 3 assists out there while also playing some lockdown defense. You have him on the team there with, Andre Iguodala off the bench. And all of a sudden, like, Kobe, I mean, you know, who was their backup shooting guard this season? I think it was, what, like Nick Young? So that is a big upgrade right there in that sense. Just like what he would be able to provide, at least like in the locker room for this team. And then, of course, man, like it would be so low pressure because of the dominance of this team already. But let's go ahead, guys, and start the simulation out here. Because I do want to talk a little bit about Kobe Bryant and just like his legacy as a player and some of the things going on with him in his NBA career, you know, in like recent news and stuff like that. So, I think Kobe Bryant is kind of going through a little stage of, I don't know the correct word for it, but I mean, like, people always say, like, yo, Kobe Bryant, like, he's Michael Jordan right there. He's a Michael Jordan cologne. Where now, when you talk about, like, the GOAT discussion, it's all about LeBron James and Michael Jordan. So, if Kobe Bryant were to come back to the NBA and win, like, another championship or two, I don't want to say in a ring-chasing role because, I mean, yeah, it kind of, like, is low-key ring-chasing, but he would still contribute to a team out there. Would you guys, like, use that in an argument, you know, when it comes to Kobe Bryant, instead of saying, like, yo, Kobe Bryant, you know, he won 5 championships, but if he, like, ring-chased and got, like, 2 more, would you, like, consider that, like, part of his legacy, or would you say, no, man, like, it's only the original 5 that counts? Those last 2 don't really mean anything, because, like, right now, man, like, if Vince Carter was to win a championship, would you be like, yeah, like, Vince Carter won himself a championship ring, like, he's a Hall of Famer, like, obviously he's a Hall of Famer, but would you use that in the discussion when it comes to himself as a great player, or would you say something like, you know, like, he never really earned it himself out there, you know what I'm saying, man? Because there, I will say, though, when it comes to the GOAT discussion of Kobe Bryant, the thing that just completely just baffles me that people, like, hate on Kobe for is saying that, you know what, Kobe Bryant never won without a dominant big man, Pau Gasol and Shaquille O'Neal. I don't really understand that because pretty much in any case, an NBA player, a superstar that's won a championship has had other like all-star or superstar help. Like, why does it matter that it was a center? You know what I'm saying? Because obviously Michael Jordan had Scottie Pippen. You know, LeBron James had Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love, or Chris Bosh and Dwayne Wade. I mean, Dwayne Wade won one with Shaquille O'Neal when he was out of his prime and stuff like that. I don't really understand that hate against Kobe Bryant, say he could not win without a big man. It's like, yeah, they were definitely part of his team, but any great player that's won a championship has had help from other guys out there. So I really don't understand the argument, man. Maybe you can enlighten me in the comment section below and talk a bit more about that. But another thing I want to ask you guys about Kobe Bryant is, do you guys kind of feel like that Mamba mentality is gone? Do you feel like Kobe Bryant was the end of a, you know, kind of like an era of just really hard-nosed working players out there that just were like, want to like kill you out there, man? Because I'm trying to think of a player in the NBA right now that I'm like, yo, that might be the next Kobe Bryant. And I just don't really see that work ethic from anybody in the NBA. Now, some of that might just be because we are just in a different era as people, you know, and just like mankind and stuff with social media and all that stuff that did not really exist during Kobe Bryant's era. And I feel like that's a big part of it, man. You know, people in the NBA now, it's not so much they want to go out there and just like beat you down. They want to kind of be friends out there, which is completely fine. I do understand that. I just don't know. It's just, I was kind of interested by that when I was trying to think of somebody. Kind of think like, yo, Donovan Mitchell. But to me, he's not the next Kobe. He's like the next, like, Dwayne Wade. So, just kind of an interesting thing that I want your guys' thoughts about in the comment section. Well, if you think the Mamba mentality is just completely gone from the NBA and players like that are never going to be around ever again. Looking at the record of this team, though, you know, 59-22. So, still, once again, guys, a very good team out there, assimilate through date. And finished with, 59 wins on the season. I am curious if Kobe's going to get Sixth Man of the Year. So MVP is Russell, Ben Simmons, Rookie of the Year, and Kobe Bryant off the bench, man. Damn, dude. 17 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, 1 steal per game. Shot 41% from 3. And that's exactly what you would get because it's like, if Kobe Bryant is out there playing with Kevin Durant and Stephen Curry and Klay Thompson in a lineup, it's like, you ain't going to be double-teaming Kobe. You're not going to be double-teaming the 39-year-old man out there. So, you know, him being able to play like one-on-one against some of these young bloods out there in the offensive set, that would be pretty cool to watch. Let me check out these All-NBA teams. Yo, what if Kobe Bryant low-key made one, man? I'd be absolutely crazy. No, he did not, but it's all good. Yeah, I was not expecting those type of stats. Like, the assists and rebounding, I was correct. I guess I did say, like, 13 points. So, you know, 16, 17 points out there. It's not like that big of a jump. Let's check out the team stats real quick. Here's how we did scoring wise. We were the best scoring team in the NBA. Makes sense. Defensively, also up there too. And of course, 3-point wise, we probably were like the best. Yeah, 42%. Yeah, so player stats on the season. Steph Curry still did lead the team in scoring at 24 points, 5 rebounds, 8 assists. Durant, 24 points, 8 rebounds, 5 assists himself. Klay Thompson, about 20 points per game. So his stats were roughly the same. Thing about Kobe, though, is, like, you know, if he's coming out of retirement, he's not going to settle for no, you know, 10, 15 minutes a game. Like, this dude's going to want to play. Even the idea of him coming off the bench just felt kind of weird, but I felt like, man, that's the only role for him. So, we actually did go up to 81 overall throughout the season. That's probably just because, like, he was playing at, like, a stellar level and everything like that. Very cool, though, man. And I also wonder, do you guys think he would make an all-star team? Because he probably would, actually. Okay. But you know what, man? We try to win Kobe Bryant a championship ring, so we are going to be going against Utah Jazz in the first round of the playoffs. Simulate current round, see how this goes. Gotta get the Black Mamba another ring out there. Beat them 4 games, won Kobe Bryant in the closeout game, at just 26 minutes. Dropped 22 points on 8-for-14 shooting. He just absolutely is being very consistent out there. Next up, we do have the San Antonio Spurs, so simulate current round here, and got them 4 games, the 2 close out game, 36 for Stephen Curry, 25 for Durant, 23, 4, and 3 for Kobe Bryant. He definitely is taking a lot of shots. I was expecting more about like 10 shots a game, something along those lines, but he's right up there, man. Like, he's like, yo, I'm shooting that ball. I'm Kobe Bryant. You know, I shoot. Next up, the Houston Rockets. Hopefully we can get past them, simulate current round. And all right, I mean, for some reason, the Houston Rockets, I don't want to say it for some reason, because, you know, if Chris Paul was healthy, who knows, maybe they would have actually beat the Golden State Warriors in real life. But closeout game, 27 points for Kevin Durant, 31 for Stephen Curry. We got 16 for Kobe on 6-for-15 shooting. Didn't make a lot of threes, though. I do want to see what his playoff stats were overall on this. Playoff stats. He did drop 20 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists. I don't care what anybody says, man. Kobe Bryant is one of the GOATs of the NBA. Do I think he is the GOAT? No, I do not. But at the same time, I really don't know who is. Because there's arguments for everybody out there, man, as far as like LeBron James, Michael Jordan. I'm sure there's even an argument for Kobe Bryant that could be found if you try hard enough. But anyway, guys, hope you all enjoyed this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to drop that like, subscribe if you're new to my channel. And let me know in the comment section below if you want me to do some more of these videos with maybe taking some of the recent retired players out of the NBA and trying to help them win an NBA championship in a bench role. All right, guys, peace out.